मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द पंचुएशन एंड कैपिटलाइजेशन, विच इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर द इंग्लिश ग्रामर. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्लास वी विल बी लर्निंग कैपिटल लेटर्स, फुल स्टॉप, कॉमा, कोटेशन मार्क, आई मीन क्वेश्चन मार्क, एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क एंड एपोस्ट्रॉफी. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द कैपिटल लेटर. स्टूडेंट्स, there are some rules to use capital letters. So first rule is, whenever you are starting a sentence, okay, so whenever you are writing a starting a or beginning a sentence, you will write first letter in capital. Clear? This means that after a full stop you always use a capital letter, right? Now titles, in title you always use a capital letter, right? In titles, capitalize only the important words, not minor words such as and but. So students, you write the heading of chapters, right? So you write each word's first letter capital, but you should not write minor word capital. For example, of. Or you can say, students, there was a chapter in 7th class, it was the story of Stepwell. So stories S will be capital, stepwells S will be capital, but we will not capitalize which word? Of. O will not be capitalized. Clear? So in title we capitalize major words, not minor words. So I think I am clear to you. Now proper nouns, you know very well that what is proper noun. Proper nouns are the nouns which are specific. Clear? So when we talk about a particular person, place, animal, things, that are called the proper noun. So proper nouns are always capitalized. So you can see some examples written over here. Jane, John, so these are the name of person. So it, the first letter will be capitalized. Oxford University, so it is a name of a university, then it will also be capitalized. So you can ask yourself your name, your school name, that is St. Austin School. So St. S capital, A capital, right? So this is how you have to write capital letter in pronouns. Now students, why do we use punctuation mark? Student, we use punctuation because it help the reader to clarify, understand the message that is being conveyed. So when we use punctuation mark, our message is more clear to the other person, means to whom we are conveying. Clear? So we need to use punctuation mark to make our reading or writing understandable. Clear? So now students, we will learn the use of full stop. So where to use full stop? Student, the full stop is also called the period. It is chiefly used to mark the end of a sentence expressing a statement. So whenever there is a statement, you need to insert full stop at the end of the statement. Clear? You can see the example written over here. Tara has completed her work. So we have used the punctuation here, full stop, because this is a statement, and at the end of the statement we use punctuation, that is, you know, full stop. Now students, where to use commas? Commas separate ideas, add pauses, and help you to list things clearly. We use commas to separate words and word groups in a simple series of three or more items. So student, whenever you are listing anything, okay, so your list will, suppose your list is having more than three words, then it will be, there will be use of comma. So you can see the example. My estate goes to my husband, son, daughter-in-law and nephew. So you can see that there is a comma after husband, son and daughter-in-law. Okay, so this is how you can use comma. Now you use comma where two independent clauses are joined by connectors. Connector means conjunction, such as and, or, but, etc. So whenever there are two independent clauses joined together with the conjunction, in that case you will use conjunction. Okay, he walked all the way home and he shut the door. It is incorrect. To correct it, he walked all the way home, comma. Why we have used comma? Because now this sentence is connecting with the connector. Okay, so before conjunction we will use comma. So I think it is clear to you. Now students, we will learn the use of a question mark. So where to use a question mark? Students, a question mark is placed at the end of a sentence, which is a direct question. Whenever you are asking any question, you will insert question mark at the end of the sentence. So what is the capital of India? We have inserted question mark because this group of words is asking something. So it is a interrogative sentence, and in interrogative sentences we use question mark. Now an exclamation mark, the exclamation mark, this is used at the end of a sentence or a short phrases which expresses very strong feeling, right? Which expresses strong feeling or emotion. So here is the example, what a lovely view you have here, right? Now the last use of apostrophe. Where to use apostrophe? We use apostrophe to form possessive nouns. Means if you are showing ownership, in that case you will use apostrophe. Ram's pen, Rita's book. So in this sentences or phrases we have used apostrophe to show the ownership, or you can say possession. Clear? To show the omission of letters. Sometimes the letters are omitted, or you can say skipped, like you are. So this is read, we will read it as R, right? So here A is missed, and this is missed, and that's why we have used what? Apostrophe. So we use apostrophe to show the omission. Clear? So this is all for today's class. We will meet in the next class with a new topic. Till then, stay home, stay safe, be happy. Thank you.